The drivers are being really wary about it. So there's long queues in both directions. People are finding alternative routes. But if you can see an update on that, I'd really appreciate it. I'll give you the number in a moment. Campbell Road in Stoke remains closed for police investigation work between Mitton Roundabout and Birmingham Road. That'll affect you if you get into the match later on. It's still like that. And find temporary traffic lights on the A34 Stone Road in Stafford. That's near the McDonald's Roundabout. Church Lane. If you see anything else, you can start putting people down. As always, it's 0800 121 8080. In the next few moments, though, they call it the cutest quiz on the radio. Little Maxie is back. Can you work out what song he's singing? Clue number one, find out what he's been up to this week after this from David Guetta. John in Bucknell, who else we got here now? Oh, Sean in Nantwich, thank you very much for your texts. Now then, let's do this.
Kids sing the funniest things.
The star of the show is...
Hi, I'm Max, and I'm 8 years old. I'm from Northumbly Moors. My mum makes me say the Northumbly Moors bit, because she says it makes a sound pop.
So if you've never heard this before, it is very simple, it is very straightforward. We get little 8-year-old Max from North of the Moors to come on and sing a song that you definitely, definitely know. We thrust the microphone into his face and we force him to sing along to a song that you've heard on BBC Radio Stoke. Told you it was simple. Little Maxie, how's your week been? You been up too much?
Well, Robert, I heard about your Spanish escapade. just think your passport is probably being used to smuggle Carlos the Jackal into South America. I'd love to read your review on TripAdvisor. I bet there's more bile and anger than Lee Blakeman's listener feedback. If it's any constellation, I've had a great week. Bit of swimming, bit of trombone practice, another visit to the Cubs. We've been learning the skill of map reading this week. Mum says it can be a real lifesaver when you're out in the wild. In fact, you've got the survival instincts of Bear Grylls and Oliver Reed, sleep on the moors, and she'll still know the quickest route to the nearest off-license. Mind you, after 13 Prosecco's, she can't find her way from the sofa to the bed, and even from the area you've covered up in mice. You know what she's like.
As always, I'll give you in a second. First clue of three is this.
My heart went when I crossed the room and I held her hand in my ear. My heart went when I crossed the room and I held her hand in my ear.
Seconds.
quarter to 12, Saturday morning, BBC Radio Stoke playing Pulp and Common People. We're definitely doing some chair dancing to that one, Steve. No doubt about it.
I cannot lie, Robinson. Probably was.
It's a good song, isn't it? It is a good, good song.
It is.
How the devil are you,
Mark?
I'm fine, thank you. Very well.
What's been going on in your world?
It's been okay, actually, because now I've got the vision and everything, I'm sort of like, I'm set, alright now.
So, for the people that missed the show 2 weeks ago, you are now cataract clear, aren't you?
Yeah, that's right.
How has it improved your life? You're not looking for a divorce now, you can see properly, and you can see your husband, are you?
No, I just don't take the eyes out of crafting, that's all. She can't, so, you know.
Definitely not. So Little Maxi is on this morning. What are your thoughts on Little Maxi's song this week, Maury?
We're still pondering that. We're trying to work out what it is, because it is familiar, but I'm just trying to think what it is.
Do you want to hear it again, Steve?
Yeah, should hear it again, but it's this one.
Week, which meant I had an extra few days in Madrid, which
I didn't
particularly want. However, in that bag was my favourite jumper. Did you miss me talking about this earlier on? Did you hear this, Mario?
Yeah, I'd gone to the shop, so I kind of missed that one.
What about you, Steve? Did you hear us talking about it?
Really, Mario? You didn't have to say you missed it, because you know now he's going to talk about it.
Yeah.
In
the bag that was stolen last week when we were in Madrid, it was many, many things, all somewhat replaceable, apart from this one beautiful black jumper. It fit perfectly wherever it touched. It was soft, it was dreamy, it was like a warm cuddle from a loved one. Every time I put it on. And do you know what the best thing about it was, Steve? Every time I put it on, I felt like $1 million. I felt like I'm a take on the world. But unfortunately, it was taken from me, along with my other possessions, by a manky-toothed get in Madrid.
Oh dear.
So when you go back tonight, when you are wandering around your house and you see something that you think, oh, I'd be really upset if I weren't to have you tomorrow, you just look longingly at it. Give it a little stroke if you like, Mari. Just let it know what you think about it, because one day